Hello and welcome to another Angling Times live tackle test. We're here today at Rolf's Lake in Oxfordshire. Now this lake was once owned by a chap called Rolf Wobberking, who was a real character and is also quite a good specimen angler in his own right. This lake has held the British match record and it also holds some fabulously big fish. We're not here just to fish this lake though, we're here to take a look at the world's most expensive fishing pole. Come with me. So, here we are then. These are probably considered the best two poles currently in the world. On my right hand side, the new Daiwa Air, and on the left hand side is the Airity, the previous Daiwa flagship pole. Now ever since the Air's come out, I've been asked lots of questions about, is it any lighter, is it any stiffer, what makes it better, and is it worth that extra amount of money? Well, I've got to the end of the pole. Both of these are set up at 16 metres in a very similar fashion to you would be fishing with them, and as you can see on the stiffness front of 16 meters there is virtually nothing in it, maybe 3/4 of an inch between the two. So I'm going to walk down the air and we're going to talk a little bit more about the technical advances that can be found in this pole. Now exclusive to the air is a hyper MSG low resin content material that makes the pole a little bit stiffer, as we can see. It also gives it a sharper recovery, which is the tip bounce post-strike. This material is formed on the whole core of the pole, not over one particular section. It runs the length of the pole. Once you get to the fourth section, the actual taping system is much closer than it is on the Airity, and that also gives it an improved performance in handling when you're shipping back. You can probably hear it, but you can certainly see it. You move down the pole, the middle of the pole, very similar, the sections are the same length. Don't forget this pole is built off of the same mandrel. Once we come off of the seventh joint onto the eighth joint, we come off of the ITS taper system, we come onto the diamond satin finish that runs the whole length of the eighth, the ninth, the tenth, and the 11th sections. Every section has got the same joint alignment systems and it is very, very smooth. What Daiwa say is the Air is a better pole used long. So 16, in fact, we'll fish with it in a minute. We'll put it up to 17, maybe even 18 metres, and we'll see if we can find that difference. But the two together, there isn't a great deal of difference to see. It's all in the fishing and the handling of this pole. So we'll have a little fish with it and see what we can catch. Right, so we've just hooked the first carp of the session. The new Air, as you can see, and there's plenty of power. There's no short fall with this pole, but it doesn't seem to be affecting the power in the pole at all. It's fitted with a black hydro. As you can see, the lightness and balance of the pole gives me lots of maneuverability on the pole. I mean, that's not actually what you do playing the fish. Shipping back, very easy. I don't know how big this fish is, but most stuff in Rolf's is fairly big. Shipping is easy. We'll get back onto the puller kit as quickly as we can. It's come apart easily. Yes, there's lots of power in this power top kit. I don't think this is the biggest fish in Rolf's, but it's certainly not a small one. Oh, and there's just so much power in this pole. Ridiculous. Look at that. Huge carp. Landed in probably under a minute. One of Rolf's finest. Well, actually John's now. Right, well, as often happens at this time of year, I think there aren't so many fish in the open water here in this gully between the two lakes, and I think the fish are right over towards those trees that are on the far bank. Now, I've put the Airity extensions on this pole and we'll have a go at 18 metres, which is a lot of pole, but we should just be able to see how stiff and how good this pole is when it's fished very long. So everything's on the joint alignment arrows. Now, something you could notice here is just how stiff the end of this pole is as you ship out. It's not bouncing around. If you had a toss pot on there, it wouldn't be, you know, wouldn't be tipping out. It's very stiff. So here we go, we're on 14. We're off the 14, we're up to 16. Now we're on 17. Right the way up to 18. And at 18, on a very short line, get the float right underneath the trees to where the fish are. Now I have to say, I've fished with poles of this length before, and they're not easy no matter what poles they are, but this, as you can see, not too bad, and we're still on a very short line. You wouldn't need, you know, there's enough stiffness there if we get a bite for it to be still very quick. And I have to say, that is hugely impressive. So, to sum up, the Daiwa Air. Almost certainly this will be regarded as the best pole in the world. I wouldn't have any argument with that. It's got an all-round usage. It will be as good as anything you could have to fish across a canal at 13, 40 metres, really shallow catching gudgeon because of its recovery rate and its speed through the hand. You can use it for catching silly fish like here at Rolf's. It'll withstand it. There is nothing you can't do with that pole. And because of that reason, this is the world-class pole. This will be the pole that everybody will aspire to own. So, I've had a great few hours at Rolf's. It's brought back loads of fond memories for me. The fish are every bit of as immaculate as they ever were. John Bennett's running a great fishery here. And the Daiwa Air pole, yeah, I'm absolutely in love with it. What a fabulous bit of kit that is. Anyway, let's pop my old mate back in. And until next time, keep watching.